This is the DieselJet 625. The flagship model in the Williams DieselJet range. 6.3 meters long, 2.4 meters wide, and capable of 46 miles an hour. Widely regarded as the ultimate do-it-all luxury yacht tender. Just as comfortable shuttling up to 10 VIP guests from ship to shore as ripping around the bay towing a wakeboarder, the 625 can be relied upon to perform its multiple daily duties with ease and finesse.
So, let's take a closer look at all the features on board. At the back of the boat, one of the main features that your eye will be drawn to straight away is the jet pump. All of our boats are jet driven, meaning they suck water in under the intake under the hull and they fire it out the back to give you forward propulsion. The reason we do jet tenders primarily is because they allow you to have a very low overall height and a very condensed overall length. So when we're fitting into tight garages on board super yachts, production yachts, having that really small envelope size where you're really maximizing the tender in the garage is super important. So a jet really allows you to do that because it's within the limit of the GRP molding at the back here. So what you'll see, the bucket here allows you to achieve your forward, neutral and reverse. So when you're going forward, the bucket is fully out of the way, uninterrupted flow of water. In neutral, it's half over the flow, which means half the water is going out the back and half the water is being redirected to the front to give you a true neutral. And then in reverse, the bucket drops fully over the nozzle and that redirects all the water forward back towards the bow to give you a full reverse. On this boat, you can see we've got some underwater lights by Lumishore Specs, which give you blue, white. We can also do fully RGB coloured lights if that's your thing. The way we design our boats is trying to make sure they work with people who want to go swimming and wakeboarding and water skiing. So you'll see that we've got the water ski pole at the back here. We've also got a removable bathing ladder, which goes in and out like so, which makes it super easy for guests to get back on board after they've been swimming or wakeboarding. Lots of handholds as well, so it's easy to pull yourself in. Fitting at the back here, that's for your navigation lights. So when you're moving about at night, you can pop the removable light in so you comply with regs. And then in the daytime, you can take it off and store it in one of the forward lockers. So there's a couple of key features in this rear footwell that I want to show you guys. First off, you've got your towing valve access through this rear hatch on the rear face here. Towing valve, really important on a jet tender. When you're towing between bays or on short passages, you want to make sure it's closed. The reason being, if it's left open, water can find its way back up through the exhaust system and into your engine. So always super important, even on short passages, it's better be safe than sorry, close that towing valve. This customer has also fitted a freshwater shower on board this tender. So a small hose plugs into there, that reaches out the back, and it means that when guests are getting back on board, if they've been swimming or wakeboarding, they can quickly shower themselves off, prevents that salt water coming into the seating area and leaving marks. Also, you can see we've got the ski pole storage. So when that's not in use and you need the height in a garage, for instance, you pop it out, pop it away. Lots of handholds in this area as well. So you've got handholds on the tube, handholds between your legs, which really helps those guests feel secure and really sitting in the tender. So I'm arguably sat on the best seat on board, the helm seat. So the first thing I wanna show you here is that you've got lots of space. I'm 6'4", so I'm on the taller end of the spectrum, but even for me, I've got loads of leg room, steering wheel fits nicely, throttles fall right to my hand. It's a really nice spacious helm layout that we've got here. A key feature here is the twin lever. So this allows you to control on the right-hand lever your bucket with forward, neutral and reverse, and on the left-hand lever it's your throttle. Lots of people look at this and they're not entirely sure about the whole system because people are generally used to driving single lever boats. But there's a real benefit to this system, which I always try and tell people that it allows you for that real close quarters maneuvering. So you leave your throttle literally down at the bottom, no, very little RPM, and you drive the boat just on the bucket. Because even in neutral, you'll have a little bit of creep, which allows you to spin in your own length. But also by just driving it on the bucket, you can be so pinpoint accurate alongside the mother yacht or alongside the quay when you're picking up guests. It really does help you drive the tender very smoothly, which is key when you've got guests on board. This customer on this particular boat has specified the Raymarine Axiom 9-inch chart plotter here, which does your chart. It can also do your engine data alongside that, and it also links directly into the Fusion music system on board, so you don't need a separate head unit to run the music. Also, we've got a Raymarine VHF, very important. We always recommend that for most diesel jets. And the main display here in front of the steering wheel is the Raymarine I70, which gives you all of your key driving data that you want to monitor as you're going along. So it gives you things like oil pressure, load, boost PSI, and obviously things like RPM, speed, fuel level, and your fuel burn whilst you're moving along. Up on the top here, you've got a bank of Carling switches, which give you things like the LED deck lights, the underwater lights, your horn, and the freshwater shower. And you've also got your battery isolators, which are super important, they're very prominent. This boat has only got one battery fitted, but a lot of our diesel jets, over 75%, will be fitted with an auxiliary battery to give you that extra safety. A key feature on all of our diesel jet tenders is the fact that we've got folding windscreens or folding helms. So on the two larger models, the 565 and the 625, we've got windscreens that fold down. So just on this thumb screw here, you'll undo that, just like so. Drop your steering wheel into the lowest position, and then that folds down. That means in the really tight garage fitments that we often are dealing with, you can really reduce the overall height of the tender. This, in conjunction with an auto bow inflator, removable upholstery, it allows you to completely condense that overall height down to its lowest possible. So with this 625 being designed principally as a yacht tender, it's really important within the design that we have suitable boarding. So as you can see on this boat, we've got port and starboard tube step pads. So these come as standard on all of the diesel jet range, giving you that stable footing when you're going from the parent yacht or from the quay into the tender. That coupled with the boarding pole that you see here really gives you that point of contact with the tender that allows you to easily get on board. This boarding pole is a break in half. So you unscrew it, put it together, and then that gets stored in one of the forward lockers under this piece of upholstery. So another key requirement on any tender is storage for your guests. So under the front piece of upholstery here, you've got port and starboard lockers separated. So you can keep your valuables, your rucksacks, your dry clothing in one locker, and then flippers, snorkel, all your bits and bobs in the port locker. Also separate to those two lockers is the main anchor locker, keeping that wet, salty anchor away from your valuables in its own separate area. The 625 has got a really nice layout. It's rated to carry 11 people, but when we're designing our hulls, we have to take into account that at points we'll have a full load of 11 people on board, but at other times the boat would only be running with one or two people. So trying to spread that weight load is quite key in the way the hull shape works. What you've got is a really nice central driving position for the helm. So when they're on their own, really nice fore and aft balance, but it also, with our layout, it allows you to move passengers fore and aft, also keeping them away from any spray if they're running in windier, choppier conditions. So what we've got here is the heart of the boat. This is a Yanmar 4LV common rail diesel engine. It's a 2.8 litre four-cylinder turbocharged diesel unit. This particular model, the customer has specified 195 horsepower, but you do have the option to run it at 230 horsepower as well. Safety is obviously of paramount importance on board all boats, and on our diesel jet range, you've got an automatic fire suppression system, which is based on a temperature. So if it sees a certain level of heat buildup in the engine bay, it will automatically trigger. You've also got your automatic bilge pump, which is located right at the lowest point in the bilge, right below the CV joint for the drive shaft. A really useful option that's available on all of our diesel jet models is the ability to have an automatic full or bow tube inflator. So it's a compressor that sits in the engine bay, and it allows you to have fully deflated tubes or just the bow section, and via one of the Carling switches on the dash, you flick it on and it will automatically inflate the tube. So for people with very tight garage fitments, again, they can deflate the tube, store the tender, launch it, and within 5 minutes they've got a fully inflated tube without having to manually blow it up. As standard, all of our diesel jets come with four lifting points: port starboard, forward aft, which with a set of lifting strops allow you to come to a single point for lifting. We also have the option for tight garage fitments for a single point lift. So a piece of framework that ties into the stringer the engine sits on comes up over the engine to a single point. So you would remove this piece of upholstery, unscrew a hatch, attach your lifting eye, and then you can lift from that single point. That means it's a lot lower lift height for people in tight garages.
Thanks for watching this DieselJet 625 walkthrough video. If you like this style of content and would like to see more in the future, don't forget to hit the subscribe button.